There is no one here beside me, and my problems have all gone. There is no one to but you got to have friends. The feelings are so strong. You got to have friends to make that day last long. I had some friends, but they're gone. Saw them came and took them away, and from the dust till the dawn. Here is where I'll stay, standing at the end of a real long road. Like the Dead Sea, many of them in complete and utter shock.
because they have never really, truly, honestly experienced the divide. They want to know how much more they have to endure before I sing one of those inspirational ballads they love me for. You are the wind beneath my wings. You are the wind beneath my wings. Later. And who have we got down here in the front row? Oh, my nerves. My stars and garters. It's the American Express gold card ticket holders. Yuppie swine! Paid all that money so they could watch the show like this. Oh my God, she's so tall, I had no idea. And how is every little thing over in Hillsboro? Well, I appreciate your efforts to get close enough to see. I look good. And you want to know something? Y'all look pretty good yourselves. I had no idea what y'all would be wearing or what condition y'all would be in. I don't get out much. I don't have to.
That's what I'm talking about.
I'm a star. I spend all my free time lounging in the largest trailer on the lot, playing with my remotes. I'm totally plugged into my nation. And oh, what a nation, oh my God. Celebrities running amok and camera crews running after them. CNN chasing DNA. Figure skating is a contact sport. Canings and complainings. I only pay attention to the big events, you see. War, revolution, blood, famine and plague. The Cold War ended. Well, the ethnic wars began. The Berlin Wall fell down. I say, put the fucking thing back up. Yeah, I got an attitude. I got an ego that don't matter when you go where we go. Give me attitude, not a platitude. My gratitude to receive. Never been too fond of fragile. Oh, as quick, ever agile. Oh, my God. I'm a little old for this rapping shit. But you must admit I look good. Every time I'm walking in the room, that's right. I look so good. She looks good, though. And I'm a hell of a girl. I'm a load of fun. I look good. But you got to get to know me. Regrets. She's unable to lunch today. On my nerves, she is sorry to be delayed. But last evening, the diamond lover's lane, she strayed. Madam, Miss Otis regrets she's unable to lunch today. When she woke up and found that her dream of love was gone, madam, she ran to the man who had led her so far astray. And from under her velvet gown, she drew a gun and shot her lover down.
You should have seen it coming.
Madam, Miss Otis regrets she's unable to lunch today. Thank you. All right, girls, hustle those bustles. And don't forget to iron those outfits for the next number. I gotta keep them busy, otherwise they get into mischief. Out of town, away from their spousal equivalents. Oh my God, so Bay Boomers, what do you know? The Giants meet the Twins. I know how y'all love a major league team, and since I'm not on strike, I thought I'd show you mine. Yes, this is the last stop on my World Cups tour. I hope, I really do hope, that you enjoy my personal mountain view. Okay, all right. Four tit jokes. That ought to hold you through the ballads. Oh, my God. Oh, I know you love me. I know you love me. But you're confusing me. I forgot where I am. I'm so thrilled and delighted that you managed to find me out here at the world-famous Shoreline Amphitheater in the middle of no fucking where! Nowhere! It's always been my ambition to play a former landfill! Please take note! I was nice enough not to say toxic dump! How did you find this place? We just drove for fucking ever! Just forever! And I didn't even know what direction we were going in. Oh, we're so touched that you came to see us. We are. We are. You know, the Queen of England was just visiting Canada, and all the other queens are coming to visit me. It's so fabulous. It's just desserts. And we're thrilled and delighted that you came. Now that we've been made so aware, of course, of all the many and varied entertainment possibilities available to you in the Bay Area. Yes, it was either us or the Monster Truck Rally at Livermore. We won! I'm so thrilled. Did I sing the ballad yet? Was it wonderful? Sometimes my mind goes on CD shuffle. It does. Too many CDs, and then you press random, and any old thing comes out, that's my mind. That's my brain. I tell you, I have got to stop reading the tabloids. My mind is littered with Bobbitts and Buttafuoco's. I still can't believe there were actually two women who were willing to have sex with Joey Buttafuoco. That should have been his defense. That and the fact that his wife liked him before she was shot in the head. I still worry about her. I'll tell you who I'm really worried about. Lisa Marie Presley. I don't think she understands why they call it Neverland. I guess she'll find out soon enough. Not my problem. God, I'm so glad I'm up here and I'm not down there in the middle of all that madness. My God, it would be overkill, total overkill, tabloid overkill. It's such a strange place, Los Angeles, you know? You know, if you go to the hospital in Los Angeles and you pay with your Visa card, they give you frequent flyer mileage. True. I had a girlfriend. She had her appendix out. She got 2 weeks in Guadalajara. While she was in Guadalajara, she got dysentery. She had to go back in the hospital. That time she got phlebitis, cystitis, and a yeast infection. Those got her a trip around the world. She couldn't find anyone who would travel with her.
tired to sleep. And some people laugh when they need to cry, and they never know why. Didn't anybody tell them that's not how it has to be? Didn't anybody love them like you love me? Some people ask if the tears have to fall, then why take your chances? Why bother at all? And so need to be kissed. Doesn't anybody tell them? Doesn't anybody see? Doesn't anybody love them like you love me? 'Cause that's all.
I was a sentimental thing, threw my heart away each spring. Now a spring romance hasn't got a chance. Promised my first dance to winter. All I've got to show is a splinter. Spring this year has got me feeling like a horse that never left the folds. I lie in my room staring up at the ceiling. Spring can really hang you more. Just to kill the lonely hours, spring can really hang you up the most. All afternoon, the birds twitter twin. I know the tune. This is love, this is it. I've heard it before. Became of you, dear. condition must be chronic. Spring can really hang you up the most. All alone, the party is over. Old man Winter was a gracious host. But when you keep praying for snow to hide the clover, spring can really hang you up the
We're moving right along. I can tell by those big sky chords. We are about to plunge headlong into some important
and familiar
material.
Honey, she's gonna sing something we know. Something from the 70s. Oh, you're so cheap. Whether you're a mother or whether you're a lover, you're staying alive. I will survive. I will survive at the YMCA. Rock the boat, don't rock the boat, baby. Tip the boat, don't tip the boat over. Rock the boat, don't rock the boat, baby. Tip the boat. Do the hustle! Dr. Kevorkian, what a fabulous character, huh? He doesn't like to be called a murderer. He prefers to be called a death facilitator. Gotta be so careful what you call people nowadays. Everyone's so fucking sensitive. Can't call a junkie. Now you gotta say, he's chemically dependent. Can't call anybody bald. Now you have to say, he's follically deprived. Dan Quayle was cerebrally challenged. Someone cuts the cheese in the elevator, you may no longer say, P.U. Now you must say, someone has been hygienically dysfunctional. The plane won't crash, it simply will fail to maintain altitude. Oh my God, they're dismantling our language before our very eyes and we're not even fighting back. Do I sound hysterical? Do I look hysterical? I am hysterical. It's the caffeine, I tell you. The espresso, the latte, the mocha, the macchiato. Oh God, I gotta lie down. Wasn't that a fabulous segue? I thought that was a brilliant segue. You know, you see, when Jerry Garcia wants to fall on the floor, he just falls on the floor. He doesn't make a big deal out of it. I have to exaggerate. Oh my God, I feel like I'll never get up. The weight of the world is too much with me. I worry too much. I probably worry more than anybody in this tent. I do. I lay awake nights saying to myself, why? Why, oh, why did Paula and Emilio break up? I still haven't gotten over Sonny and Cher. Who's next? Siegfried and Roy? I worry about the Pope. Poor old thing, he just had his hip replaced. Now he has something in common with every little old lady in Miami Beach. Well, that and the hats and the dresses. worry. I worry about the Emperor of Japan. He came to the United States and he only wanted to do three things. He wanted to see the Grand Canyon, he wanted to visit Disneyland, and he wanted to throw up on George Bush. Oh, I hope he got to do everything he wanted to do.
I worry so.
I worry about the state of Virginia. Oliver North is running for Senate. Where does he get the nerve? He's a man with a firm policy on drugs. Sell them! Even Ronald Reagan says he's guilty. Just can't remember of what. I worry. I worry so. I worry so. I worry about my inner thighs. I worry about that girl, that guy that married Anna Nicole Smith. He's 89. So's she. In a D cup. She says she married him for support. I don't think he's up to it. I worry about Bill Gates. I don't think he should go around telling people he is Microsoft. I worry about Ms. Alioto. What kind of public affairs is she supervising? I worry about my fallen idol. Bob Barker! Come on down! I guess the price was wrong. But you know, every now and again, you meet someone who's so fabulous, so decent, that everything else, all those worries, just fade into the background. Like last year, we were working, you know, in these outdoor arenas, and we met Reba McEntire. She came to see my show. Reba, yeah. She told me I look good. I guess you know what that means, don't you? Even cowgirls get the juice. I see we have a few Jewish people in the house with us tonight. Oh, how come you're sitting so far back? Didn't you have no connections? Well, at least they didn't bring the children. Last year they brought the children. It's true, it's true. I would come out on the stage with these big wide open arenas and the whole front row would be little tykes. Not little dykes, little tykes. Although, I don't know. Nowadays, you can't tell. They were wearing overalls. Who knows anymore? No, I'm sure they were children. They had that kind of vacant look on their faces, you know. And I said to myself, who would bring a child to such a vulgar display? And I really had to think about it. And I finally figured it out. It's the Jews. They want their children to experience the great Jewish entertainer. We love her. We love her. We want you to see her at her very best. She's thin now, but she'll be fat soon. I pander shamelessly to my tribe. Isn't it terrible? I love my tribe. I love all that stuff. Marriage, continuity, community. I've been married 10 years. That's 108 in show business years. I married a German fellow. I married a Kraut. He used to say every night I get dressed up like Poland and he invades me. But of course I don't say that anymore. No. Now, it's not so much a military invasion, it's more like a UN peacekeeping mission. It's my mission to keep getting a little peace. Speaking of pieces, did you hear that story about Carlos the Jackal, the terrorist, the famous terrorist that got arrested?
While he was under anesthesia for a tummy tuck and liposuction.
What ignominy. See, I would be worried about him. I'd be more worried about Zsa Zsa if I were Zsa Zsa. Carlos the Jackal, what ignominy. What hubris. Turns out he was just a pompous little popinjay. Fascinating, isn't it? God, I hope it doesn't happen to me. Here's the song. Some say love, it is a river, and it drowns the tender reed. Some say love, it is a razor that leads your soul. Some say love, it is a hunger, an endless and bliss, aching need. I say love, love, it is a flower, and you, it's so. you. Thank you. That was my first rose, and now I have another one to add to my collection. Mama Rose. From the greatest musical of them all, Gypsy. I loved her. Mama Rose, driven, overbearing, impossible. Some people say I was born to play the part. What a wonderful time I had, though. I loved her. Oh, she was fat and impossible and loud. And for those of you who missed it, Mama Rose was the mother of Gypsy Rose Lee, who was the greatest stripper since Salome. Now, I don't know how much you all know about stripping. As a profession, I mean. Because it was a profession, you know. They had a union and everything with a sensational dental plan. I guess you're surprised to see how much I know about stripping, huh? I had to do all the research on Gypsy Rose Lee and her world. And Gypsy Rose Lee's world was the show business gulag, known as burlesque, or as it was called in its own time and its own place, burlicue. Now then, how to describe burlesque? Well, it was vaudeville with an X rating. There was nothing in burlesque you'd be afraid to show your mother, as long as you could be absolutely certain your mother had seen herself naked. Naturally, I wanted to share some of the more interesting aspects of burlesque with you all tonight, but I couldn't possibly, because the best stuff is simply too dirty, if you catch my drift. And with my newfound stature, this is no longer a possibility. And don't try to force me either. Besides, I can tell just from looking at you all, you're too sophisticated to ask me to pander to your baser instincts, aren't you? Oh my God! Well, forget it! I cross the line into family entertainment. I'm going for the big bucks. I work very hard to achieve this grandeur. So if you're looking for that kind of smut, you'll have to look someplace else. Ain't that right, girls? One time I came home from a fabulous checkup. says, I got the constitution of a 20-year-old girl. Ernie says, mm-hmm. He says, I have the heart of a 20-year-old girl. Ernie said, mm-hmm. He said, I have the lungs of a 20-year-old girl. Ernie says, mm-hmm. He said, I have the liver of a 20-year-old girl. Ernie said, mm-hmm. And he looked me over and he dropped the bomb. Say, did he happen to mention your 80-year-old ass? I said, no, we didn't talk about you.
That's what keeps them coming back for more.
All right, girls, one from the vault.
Ooh, I love these.
Girls, the vault, that's the best part.
These jokes are ancient. I learned these jokes when I was 8 years old. I've been telling them 20 years. Move over, Carlos. I'll never forget it, you know. I was having tea one time with my girlfriend Clementine. The doorbell rang. There was a delivery boy there with 2 dozen roses. I opened the card. It said, hello from your boyfriend Ernie. I said, Clementine, do you know what this means? For the next 2 weeks, I'm going to be flat on my back with my legs wide open. Clementine said to me, what's the matter with you? Ain't you got a vase?
That's what keeps him coming back for more.
Ladies here.
Really?
They're going like this. Last of a dying breed, I'm telling you. Trying to bring my daughter up to be a lady. It's some proposition after she heard the mouth on me. Really, I washed her mouth out with soap the first time she said the F word.
No way.
I did. She was only 4. And she heard my show. She said, Mom, can I wash your mouth out now? Yeah, she had brought me a whole box of Tide. I'll never forget it, you know. The longest time I didn't work. It's a little boomy in here, isn't it? It's boomy, isn't it? Shit. That other Jewish girl singer, she brings her own carpet. Out the carpet. Would you mind just kind of spreading your jackets over the floor? I'll never forget it, you know. The longest time I didn't wear no underwear used to drive my boyfriend Ernie absolutely batty. One time I caught terrible cold. Ernie says, Sophie, you gotta go see the doctor. I says, okay, make an appointment for me. That's make an appointment for me. Am I talking too fast? Am I talking too slow? Should I just go fuck myself? Am I talking? Is it okay? Is it too boomy? Well, put your jackets on the friggin' floor like I told you to. What happens now? I forgot.
Finish the joke.
Huh?
Finish the joke.
Oh, the joke. Yeah, well, what's the joke? I forgot where I was.
You'll never forget it.
I think I have part-timers. When you remember some but never all of what you were talking about in the first place. I'll never forget it, you know. I caught a terrible cold. Ernie says, go see the doctor. I said, make an appointment for you. So unbeknownst to me, he rings up the doctor and he says, Doc, listen, I'm sending Soph over. She's got a terrible cold, but that's not the problem. The problem is she don't wear no underwear. Tell her the reason she got this cold is because she don't wear no underwear. You got that? Righto, said the doc. So I, like a schmuck, trot on down to the doctor's office. Doctor says, so, how you doing? Open your mouth and say, ah. I opened my mouth and I said, ah. He looked down my throat. He said, you ain't wearing no underwear. I said, I beg your pardon. He said, you ain't wearing no underwear. I said, doctor, you can look down my throat and see I ain't wearing no underwear. He says, that's right. I says, Doc, do me a favor. Look at my ass and tell me my hat's on straight.
That's what keeps them coming back for more.
I'll never forget it, you know. I had gone to the grocery store for some odds and ends. I looked around for a suitable-looking bag boy to help me into the parking lot with my purchases. On the way into the parking lot, I am ashamed to tell you all, I was overcome by an attack of passion.
bad taste. I grabbed the bag boy. I said, young man, I have an itchy booty. He said, I'm sorry, lady. I don't know one Japanese car from another.
That's what keeps them coming back.
You know, my girlfriend Clementine has to go on retreat once a year to atone for her many, many sins. She goes up north to the Little Sisters of Unbearable Chastity. Once while she was up there, she discovered she had a spiritual power, a power for healing. It wasn't long before the entire retreat was overrun by people seeking to be healed, touched by Clementine. One day, Clementine was in the shower, naked and soapy. There was a knock on the door. A large nun walked in. Yo, Clementine! There's a blind man outdoors to see you. He's got something important to say to you. Clementine says, sister, I'm in the shower, naked and soapy. I cannot receive anyone in this state. The nun says, oh, Clementine, be a sport. He's a blind man. He's got something important to say to you. Very well, says Clementine. Show him in. So the door opens. And the blind man walks in. He looks at Clementine. He says, nice tits. Where do you want the blinds?
That's what keeps them coming back for more.
Hey! A doctor, my daughter, oh, she's marrying a doctor, so if your kids need shots, just call on my daughter and ask for a husband. A doctor, give all thy may plots. Actually, right now, he's an intern. You should all make appointments if it burns when you pish. Every checkup buys a setting and a serving dish. A doctor, oh really, I'm compelling. It's a Jewish Mother's Day. Because now I can complain about every ache and a pain. And I never have to pay. Time I actually met my boyfriend Ernie for the very first time. I was in my underground parking garage in my beautiful condo down Boca Raton. The underground parking garage gate opened, and the most beautiful silver Mercedes I'd ever seen drove through the gate. Behind the wheel was the handsomest man I'd ever laid eyes on. He parked the car. Well, you know, I strode right over to it, and I said, oh, my, my, what a beautiful car. He said, do you think so? I said, oh, yes. He got out of the car. I looked him up and down. I said, and you are the handsomest man I've ever seen. Look at you. Beautiful hair, handsome arms, handsome legs, handsome torso. Why, I'll bet you even have a handsome... He said, many have written home to say so. I said, well, I personally would love to see it myself. He said, would you? I said, oh, yes. Well, long story short. He unzipped his fly, and there it was. I held it in my hand. He was a very tall man. And I said, don't you ever park in my space again!
That's what keeps him coming back. That's what keeps him coming back. That's what keeps him coming back for more.
Jokes, the specialty acts, and here are four gorgeous specialties, even as we speak.
Take four terrific girls, and only three costumes, and you're cooking up something grand. Mixing some amber lights, and elegant serene, and serving a fine jazz band.
Yes, ladies and gentlemen, tonight in the tradition of burlesque, we are proud to present the tableau vivant. Yes, living pictures. Tonight, four verities, truth, beauty, music, and art. As beauty, we present that hardy perennial, Miss Daisy Chain. As music, the wild and woolly, Iona Mink with her $1 million muff. Here's Lotta Miles as the naked truth. And lastly, as art, Penny Minto and her cubist movement. Ah, Penny, stop moving them cubes! Penny, I told you!
do? What did it get me? Scrapbooks full of me in the background. Give them love and what does it get you? What does it get you? One quick look as each of them leaves you. All your life and what does it get you? Thanks a lot and out with the garbage. They take vows and you're bad and zero. I had a dream. I dreamed it for you, June. It wasn't for me, Herbie. And if it wasn't for me, then where would you be, Miss Gypsy Rose Lee? Well, someone tell me, when is it my turn? Don't I get a dream for myself? Starting now, it's gonna be my turn. Gangway whirl, get off of my runway. Starting now, I bet a thousand. This time, boys, I'm taking the vows and everything.
Ladies and gentlemen, please join us in 15 minutes for Act Two.
No! just witness Dolores at the bottom. Now, witness Dolores at the top, where she belongs. As the Home Fishing Network proudly presents an inspirational infomercial from the one, the only, the inimitable, the unassailable, the original Little Mermaid and fierce ruling diva, Dolores DeLago!
Oh, he makes it up when he plays the lead. in that burst of patriotic fervor. Oh, I remember. I was talking to you about my 12-stroke program. The program that will show you how to raise the anchor you have attached to your life. The anchor that has plunged you 20,000 leagues beneath the sea. Now I know what you're all thinking. Why should I listen to her? She's only a mermaid in a wheelchair. But hey, I understand your condition. I am compassion incarnate. You think it's easy being green? Fuck no. I have been a victim of discrimination in all its hideous, invidious forms. I have felt the sting of racism, the bite of bigotry, and that most heinous hatred of all. Mermophobia! Which until only recently, I thought was fear of Ethel Merman. But you know, ladies and gentlemen, through my 12-stroke program, which was handed down to me by a master of the old school, I triumphed. And now I swim before you, a shining beacon in whose bosom the bright waters meet.
Oh, Lord, have mercy, Dolores.
You'll find the need in the Navy. Keep the people standing. hand in the lady. Your motherland in the navy. Join your fellow man in the navy. Come on, the people, make a stand in the navy. In the navy. They want you, they want you, they want you as a new recruit. They want you, they want you, they want you as a new recruit.
Sharks. What? Was I singing off tuna?
Get it? Tuna?
Sorry. Maybe I should practice my scales.
Why don't they stop? Can I share a private moment with you? I think I'm having a midstream crisis. Maybe it's the change. Menopause. Oh, who am I trying to kid? It ain't the change. It's my balls. They're not moving. I'm a woman with a warehouse full of balls. Maybe I should roll them in rhinestones and give them to Joan Rivers to peddle. She makes millions of dollars every week on home shopping. Who's buying all that shit? How can anybody buy hair products from Cher? She's wearing a wig. Remember, remember, remember. Remember, remember, remember. Who unplugged my Thorazine drip? I gotta be careful or they'll put me back in dry dock. Remember, remember, remember. Remember, remember, remember. Remember. How the hell could I forget the names they've called me? The insults I've had to bear. The grudges I've lived with. Well, let me tell you something about grudges, okay? You gotta hold them. Squeeze them dry. Yep. And then you gotta let them go. Unencumbered, you can follow your bliss toward a bright and shining future. And using my 12-stroke program, you will have a future. Not just tonight, not just tomorrow, but any time, any place, anywhere. From the meanest little hamlet on the Delta to the greatest metropolis in the world, you too can stand on your hind flipper and say, I'll make it.
splendor in the moonlight on a lullaby. There's something tender in the moonlight on a lullaby. And all the beaches are full of peaches who bring their ukes along. And in the glimmer of the moonlight, they love to sing this song.
Through the land.
The first song I ever recorded so long ago. One of my favorites. There's a part for you in it. I'll just point at you, all right? Especially out there on the lawn, I kind of miss you.
Labor Day. Imagine that. God, time flies when you're on Prozac. That's
the truth. Of course, you know me. I'm not on anything.
I'm high on life. Where can I get some, they want to know.
Whenever the ladies leave, the maestro always plays Love Theme from Picnic, which is a very old song from a very old movie. When I was a little girl, it was on Hit Parade. It's such a beautiful song. Love Theme from Picnic. I would sing it for you, but it's out of my range. On a picnic morning. Sound like Roseanne at the ball game. Mustn't have that. Oh, no, don't get me wrong. I adore her. I like her. She has multiple personalities. I want some. There's always someone to talk to. and you can sleep around safely all by yourself. Love theme from Picnic. Actually, it was a medley with another song, a very beautiful song from an even earlier time called Moon Glow. I can sing that one for you. That's real short range. It must have been moon glow way out on the blue. I'll always remember that moon glow gave me you. Songs about the moon and the stars. I love songs about the moon and the stars. They used to write songs about the moon and the stars constantly. They don't do that so much anymore because they can't see the moon and the stars anymore, so they don't think they'll write about them. Popular music has really, really changed. I mean, even since I was a young girl, it's really, really changed. The other day I was listening to the radio, I heard the strangest song. Bitch, bitch better have my money. Bitch better have my money. Bitch, bitch better have my money. Bitch better have my money. Bitch. That's not very romantic. Gee, what do they do for romance? Oh my God. Of course, right after that they played, I'm a loser, baby, so why don't you kill me? I feel sorry for the younger ones. They do, I feel sorry for them. Oh, I guess it's corny. Maybe it's corny. I don't know. It sure is pretty music to my ears. I don't know. It must have been moon glow. San Francisco moon keeps shining. Yeah, I love songs about... I like them. I wish I wrote songs myself. I used to write songs before I got all caught up in various other activities. I had my daughter, you know, I had my little girl, and I made movies and I made videos. And then, of course, you know, I compost. I know it's not glamorous, but it's all that was left. Sting got the rainforest. Willie Nelson got the farmers. Whoopi got the homeless. So I'm composting. In fact, next year I'm going to be named the Compost Council of America's poster girl. You think I'm joking, don't you? I got piles of that shit in my backyard to prove it. Composting is my cause. Now, for those of you who do not know what composting is, I've turned the entire nation onto composting. This is what it is. It's very simple. When you have your grass cuttings, you can leave the grass cuttings on the lawn. That's very good for the grass. The grass likes its own cuttings. But if you have leaves and you prune your tree, or you have kitchen parings, you know, eggshells, coffee grinds, orange rinds, that sort of thing, you put it all in a pile in your backyard, and the most fabulous thing happens. It decomposes. Say that word. Decomposes. Excellent. The worms come. My favorite creature. Two sexes. Eats and shits. That's what it does. Of course, I know many of you do the same. But your stuff is not worth what those little worms provide for us. And you know, when they're all done, when the thing finally decomposes, then you take all that stuff that's left over and you put it back into the ground, and it's fantastic for your fruits and vegetables. And if you have your own fruits and vegetables that you grow yourself, that you don't have pesticide on, then you'll feel a lot better. And you won't hate your neighbor so much. And you won't want to get a gun and shoot your neighbor. And I just envision world peace through composting. What do you think? What do you think? Is it too much to ask? I guess it's a big project, but that's my cause. You know, people come to me and say, Miss Divine. Oh, Miss Divine. Because they think I really am divine. And of course, you know, I do not dissuade them. They think I am a goddess, and I say, well, of course I'm a fucking goddess. Why not? You need one, babe.
might as well be me. They say, what is the meaning of life? And I tell them, the meaning of life is actually service. It's service. It's kindness to your fellow man. And you know what? It's good. It is. That's what it is. It's very simple. It's very simple. Just kindness. I think we're all here on this God-forsaken planet so that we can learn the lessons that will allow us to get off this planet and move on to higher worlds. I don't know about you, but baby, I got plenty of points in the piggy bank. Where was I? Oh yes, I was talking about popular music, saying, oh, I wish. There are songs that I wish I had written. If you're traveling in the North Country Fair, where the winds hit heavy, he doesn't know that one, my fabulous keyboard player. Where the winds hit heavy on the borderline, remember me to one who lives there. She once was a true love of mine. It was the first folk song I ever heard when I was just about 15 years old, and it changed my life forever. And I wish also I had written, you must remember this, a kiss is just a kiss, a sigh is just a sigh. The fundamental things apply as time goes by. You want to sing? Oh, curfew. Sorry. Too bad. Tough luck, San Francisco. I went to Lover's Blue. They still tell you on that you can rely. Curfew, okay. I have to be careful the songs I choose to sing because some songs are, of course, classic, and some songs have no shelf life at all. I used to have this song I used to sing called The Mill Worker, which I thought was one of the greatest songs ever written, and it is. It was about a woman who worked in the mills in Massachusetts, and she felt that she was chained to her machine, and I really identified very strongly with this song. I would cry in the middle of the second act, second chorus, because it was so sad, you know? And she and her machine, that was the whole lament of the song. And then one day the mills closed down and her job got sent to Mexico. Now she wishes she had her fucking job back. I had to stop singing the song. No longer apply. Things change, you gotta keep up. But some things never change. We had an apartment in the city. Me and my husband like living there. And it's been years since the kids have grown. A life of their own left us alone. John and live in Omaha, and Joe, he's somewhere on the road. We lost Davy in the last war. I still don't know what for. Don't matter anymore. You know that old trees just grow someone to say hello in there, hello. Now me and my husband, we don't talk much anymore. He sits and he stares out the back door screen. And all the news just repeats itself like some forgotten dream that we both see. Someday I'm gonna go call my friend Judy. We used to work together at the factory. If she should ask what's new,
nothing what's with you. Nothing much to do. You know that old trees just grow stronger and old rivers grow wider every day, every day. But old people just grow lonesome, waiting for someone to say hello there, hello.
So if you're walking down the street sometime and you should spot some hollow ancient eye, don't as if you didn't care, say hello there, say hello.
Did you go when things went wrong, babe? Who did you run to find a shoulder to lay your head upon? Babe, it wasn't I there. And tonight
with me, baby.
can get. Plenty of men. It's just keeping them. That's the hard part. Yeah, I guess sometimes I try a little too hard. But then I wonder how many of you in the house tonight go to sleep with the sound of an old love song drifting through your mind. I would work for you, I would slave for you. I would be a devil or a slave for you. And if that isn't love, it will just have to do.
Good to me. Thank you so much. Thank you. Please sit down. Okay, you waited all night for it and it's finally here. You were so good to me too. You didn't yell at me. Sing the one about the wind. You let me do my show. I'm very touched. I really am. I really appreciate your graciousness and your good humor. This song means a lot to a lot of people, you know. It was the biggest record I ever had, and when, you know, I had this outpouring of emotion about it, I had no idea what we had wrought, you know, what we had done. Everyone was so excited. This song means so much. People, for everyone you've lost, for everyone you've found, you know, when I sing this song, sometimes people, they hug and they kiss and they touch each other and they nuzzle and they, you know, they put their arms around each other sometimes. I think it's so nice. I just suggest you introduce yourselves to each other before. Enjoy yourselves. Just don't sing on my woes, okay? Sunlight on your face.
pretend to let me shine. That's your way. You always walked a step behind. So I was the one with all the glory, while you were the one with all the strength. A beautiful face without a name for sin. A beautiful smile to hide the
of the day today and any day,
my conductor, my keyboard artist, and my friend. Oh, Atlantic recording artist, Mr. Bobby Lyle.
Thank you. Thank you so very much. And ladies and gentlemen, last but certainly not least, here at the Shoreline Amphitheater, you have experienced the divine. Miss Bette Midler!
Thank you so much. Please sit down. Thank you. Oh, thank you. Before we go any further, I have to tell my saw man how much I love him, because he was hurt by my carpet joke. I thought it was hysterical myself. But he thought, people thought I was really making fun of the sound. I think the sound is brilliant. This is a really nice house. It's a beautiful house. Of course, it is, like I said, nowhere, but... but it's beautifully landscaped, and the smell only comes up once in a while, so I can't seem to stop myself. I'm sorry. It's always such a treat to come back to the Bay Area. You know, I've been coming here for many, many years, and yet I don't really know it well. I don't know it well. I wish I'm going to come back and really try to get used to it, try to, like, find my way around. I adore it. It's such a good spirit. Everyone's got such... I came in 1967 at the height of the hate. It's hard to imagine me in beads, isn't it? Yes, I know. It's great fun. Great fun. Don't make me sad. Please don't make me sad. Oh, the curfew. I just wanted to thank you for being so great. And I know you did come a long, long way. I mean, it's quite a haul to get out here. And you were really, really a fabulous crowd. So I want to say thank you to you, and I want to sing one more song for you. A friend of mine came to me the other day and said, Miss Midler, all my friends call me Miss Midler. I learned that from Diana. Miss Midler, you have a new theme song. I said, a new theme song? Baby, I got a million theme songs. I got no act. You gotta give a little. Take a little and let your poor heart break a little. That's the story of, that's the glory of love. Back and forth all night long. You gotta